guten Abend.
Let us begin with prayer.
Lass uns mit Gebet anfangen. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you that we can come now before you.
Lieber himmlischer Vater, danke, dass wir jetzt vor dir erscheinen können.
And we can only present our great need.
Wir können nur unsere große Bedürftigkeit präsentieren.
There's nothing that we are or do that that we deserve your mercies.
Also gibt es nichts, was wir sind oder tun können, was deine Barmherzigkeiten verdienen würde.
But I thank you that we can come as we are and that you are drawing us to the feet of Jesus.
Aber danke, dass wir trotzdem kommen können, wie wir sind, und dass du uns zu den Füßen Jesu ziehst.
And that you promise that the truth will make us free.
Und dass du versprichst, dass die Wahrheit uns freisetzen wird.
And help us therefore to fix our eyes on these great promises and not let go.
Und hilf uns deswegen, unsere Augen auf diese großen Verheißungen zu richten und nicht loszulassen.
Help us to learn now from you what you want to teach us this evening.
Hilf uns bitte jetzt von dir zu lernen, was du uns heute Abend lehren möchtest.
And please put away all this confusion that is on our mind and all these false doctrines.
Und bitte beseitige alle Verwirrung, die in unserem Verstand ist, und alle falschen Lehren.
That we can become this perfect offering in your sight.
So dass wir dieses vollkommene Opfer vor dir werden können.
And I ask now for your presence and for a conviction of our sin.
Und ich bitte jetzt um deine Gegenwart und um Überführung von unseren Sünden.
And that the Holy Spirit will lead us into all truth.
Und dass der Heilige Geist uns in alle Wahrheit führt.
In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesu Namen, amen. Okay, gut. So, let's turn to Zechariah chapter 1.
Gehen wir zu Zacharja 1.
This evening we want to do the study we did just recently, where we didn't record.
Und heute Abend wollen wir dieses Studium machen, was wir vor kurzem schon angeschaut hatten, aber das haben wir nicht aufgenommen.
And because we decided to stop the live stream for a few days just before the camp meeting.
Weil wir hatten ja entschieden, dass wir vor dem Camp Meeting den Livestream ein paar Tage stoppen.
Okay, good. So let's go to Zechariah chapter 1.
Gehen wir jetzt zu Zacharja 1.
Let's begin in verse 1.
Wir fangen in Vers 1 an.
It says, in the eighth month, in the second year of Darius, came the word of the Lord unto Zechariah, the son of Berechiah, the son of Iddo, the prophet, saying, the Lord hath been sore displeased with your fathers. Therefore say thou unto them, thus saith the Lord of hosts, turn ye unto me, saith the Lord of hosts, and I will turn unto you, saith the Lord of hosts. Be ye not as your fathers, unto whom the former prophets have cried, saying, thus saith the Lord of hosts, turn ye now from your evil ways and from your evil doings, but they did not hear, nor hearkened unto me, saith the Lord. So, what is basically the message the Lord gives here to Zechariah?
Was ist im Grunde die Botschaft, die der Herr dem Zacharja gibt?
Same as all the prophets, turn from your sin back to me.
Yes.
Same was all den Propheten gegeben wird, also wendet euch weg von euren Sünden hin zu mir.
Yes, and he says also, don't be like your fathers, right?
Und er sagt, seid nicht so wie eure Väter.
Okay, so and let's just continue down to verse 6.
Wir lesen noch bis Vers 6 runter.
Your fathers, where are they? And the prophets, do they live forever? But my words and my statutes, which I commanded my servants, the prophets, did they not take hold of your fathers? And they returned and said, like as the Lord of hosts thought to do unto us, according to our ways and according to our doings, so hath he dealt with us. So he basically tells them, don't repeat the sins of your fathers, because else you will have the same fate.
Also er sagt im Grunde, wiederholt nicht die Sünden eurer Väter, sonst werdet ihr dasselbe Schicksal erleiden.
Okay, so and then in verse 7,
und in Vers 7,
he sees now this vision, this first vision,
sieht er diese erste Vision.
And he sees these four horses with his rider on the red horse.
Er sieht diese vier Pferde und den Reiter auf dem roten Pferd.
So it's upon the 24th day of the 11th month, which is the month Sebat, in the second year of Darius, came the word of the Lord unto Zechariah, the son of Berechiah, the son of Iddo, the prophet, saying, I saw by night, and behold, a man riding upon a red horse, and he stood among the myrtle trees that were in the bottom, and behind him were their red horses speckled and white. So, here we see, he has a night vision, right?
Hier sehen wir, hat eine Nachtvision.
Who else had a night vision?
Wer noch hatte eine Nachtvision?
Daniel, right?
Daniel.
Okay, so Daniel had this night vision, which was which chapter?
Daniel hatte diese Nachtvision, in welchem Kapitel war das?
Yes. Okay, so just keep your finger here. Let's go to first to Daniel chapter 2 and then to Daniel 7.
Das war in Daniel 7. Und haltet euren Finger jetzt hier und geht zuerst zu Daniel 2 und danach gehen wir zu Daniel 7.
So Daniel 2, verse 19.
Daniel 2, verse 19.
Says, then was the secret revealed unto Daniel in a night vision. Then Daniel blessed the God of heaven. So this was when he saw now the statue, right?
Das war, als das Standbild gesehen hat.
So it was a night vision.
Das war eine Nachtvision.
Secret was revealed to him.
Das Geheimnis wurde ihm offenbart.
Daniel 7.
Jetzt Daniel 7.
Verse 2.
Vers 2.
Says, Daniel spake and said, I saw in my vision by night, and behold, the four winds of the heavens drove upon the great sea. And four great beasts came up from the sea, diverse one from another. So here, it's also a vision by night, right?
Das ist auch eine Nachtvision.
What does he see?
Was sieht er?
Four beasts.
Four beasts.
Vier
right?
Tiere.
And four winds.
Und vier Winde.
Right? Okay. So, when we go back to Zechariah, chapter 1.
Gehen wir zurück zu Zechariah 1.
Zechariah sees four horses, right?
Zechariah sieht vier Pferde.
So, I'm pretty sure that these things somehow can be linked, but I don't know how at the moment. Okay?
Ich bin mir ziemlich sicher, dass diese Dinge verbunden werden können, aber im Moment weiß ich nicht, wie.
Yeah, this night vision and... Yeah.
The first four seals.
No.
What do you mean?
I mean, would you say the first four seals are not the first four beasts, right? Because the first seal begins in a time of peace.
Also das wäre nicht dasselbe wie diese ersten vier Siegel, weil das erste Siegel fängt ja in einer Zeit des Friedens an.
No, okay, that might be true, but it takes you down to the fourth. The fourth seal is the fourth kingdom.
Das bringt dich zum vierten, weil das vierte Siegel ist wie das vierte Königreich.
No, that's how you do it, because in Revelation 6, the four beasts say, come and see, right? And basically, those four beasts coming up out of the sea in Daniel are this counterfeit. So, there's definitely a...
Yeah, there's a link. It's not so easy.
Es gibt eine Verbindung zwischen diesen Kapiteln, weil in den ersten vier Siegeln, da ist immer am Anfang dieses eine von diesen vier lebendigen Wesen oder Tieren erwähnt, die sagen, komm und seh. Und ja, diese vier Tiere in Daniel wären die Fälschen.
I remember when we used to show that those first four seals were... How did we do that again? We showed this very clearly that they were this counterfeit. I have to think about it.
Yes. Okay. So, let's go also to Zechariah chapter 6.
Gehen wir auch zu Zechariah 6.
Because in Zechariah 6, you know, you have now four chariots mentioned, right?
Weil in Zechariah 6 sehen wir vier Streitwagen.
With horses.
Mit okay. Pferden.
So Zechariah 1, you have these four horses. Zechariah 6, you have these four chariots of with horses.
In Zechariah 1 gibt es diese vier Pferde und in Zechariah 6 diese vier Streitwagen mit Pferden.
So chapter 6, verse 1.
Kapitel 6, Vers 1.
Says, and I turned and lifted up mine eyes and looked, and behold, there came four chariots out from between two mountains. And the mountains were mountains of brass. In the first chariot were red horses, in the second chariot black horses, in the third chariot white horses, and in the fourth chariot grizzled and bay horses. So what kind of horses do you have here?
Was für Pferde sind hier?
Red, black, white, and the last one is grizzled and bay, right?
So rote, schwarze, weiße und ja, die letzten sind so beige und was ist grizzled?
Also B ist, glaube ich, nicht beige, das ist ich glaube, das ist so eine Art rote, aber ich weiß nicht genau, 100%. Okay. Do you know what B is? I think it's kind of a red, reddish also, but a different red.
I think a bay horse is it like a dark reddy color?
Yeah, it's like, it's that shiny brown.
Yeah.
It looks like a
brown, red, yeah. Okay.
Also
chestnuts.
Das
ist so wie kastanienbraun, rotbraun und scheckig, kann es sein. Also scheckige und rotbraune Pferde.
So, if you just compare it with Zechariah 1,
wenn wir das mit Zachariah 1 vergleichen.
Just hold your finger in 6 and go please back to 1.
Haltet euren Finger in Kapitel 6 und geht nochmal zu 1 zurück, bitte.
Vers 8.
Vers 8.
So as I saw by night, and behold, a man riding upon a red horse. So you have a red horse.
Ein rotes Pferd.
And he stood among the myrtle trees, that were in the bottom, and behind him were their red horses speckled in white. So you have also then here other more red horses speckled and white. Okay.
Gibt hier noch weitere rote Pferde gescheckte und weißen.
Yes. So basically, the horses that are missing are the black horses, okay?
Die Pferde, die noch fehlen, sind die schwarzen.
So then we would have the same as in Zechariah 6. Okay.
Dann wäre es dasselbe wie in Zechariah 6.
What do you have in the seals? What horses?
Und welche Pferde haben wir bei den Siegeln?
White, red, black, and then this grizzled, sickly,
pale horse, right?
Pale horse, yeah.
Also dieses weiße, das schwarze, das rote und dann noch dieses kränkliche oder fahle Pferd.
Mm-hmm. So, these are obviously somehow in relationship. I don't fully understand it yet. Okay.
Also die stehen irgendwie in Bezug. Ich verstehe das noch nicht völlig.
But when we just continue Zechariah 6.
Aber lesen wir weiter in Zechariah 6.
And then verse 4.
Vers 4.
It says, then I answered and said unto the angel that talked with me, what are these, my lord? And the angel answered and said unto me, these are the four spirits of the heavens, which go forth from standing before the Lord of all the earth. Okay, so what are these four chariots of with horses?
Was sind diese vier Streitwegen mit Pferden?
Four spirits of the heavens.
Four spirits of the heavens, which go forth from standing before the Lord of all the earth, right?
Diese vier Geister des Himmels, die vorwärts gehen, also die haben gestanden vor dem Herrn der ganzen Erde, das sind die Cherubim.
Yes, because when you go now to Zechariah chapter 4,
weil geht zu Zechariah 4,
just to see who stands before the Lord of all the earth,
um zu sehen, wer vor dem Herrn der ganzen Erde steht. Matthäus 18.
Let's first read here, Zechariah 4, verse 3.
Zechariah 4 und Vers 3.
Because he sees the candlestick and then he sees in verse 3 the two olive trees on either side of the candlestick, right?
Also er sieht den Leuchter und in Vers 3 die zwei Ölbäume, die an der jeweiligen Seite davon
stehen. So verse 3 says, and two olive trees by it, one upon the right side of the bowl and the other upon the left side thereof. And then verse 14 says who they are.
Vers 14 sagt, wer sie sind.
Then said he, these are the two anointed ones that stand by the Lord of the whole earth. Okay, so it's the anointed ones that stand before the Lord of the whole earth, right?
Das sind die zwei Gesalbten, also die Gesalbten, die vor dem Herrn der ganzen Erde stehen.
So here it's only two, okay?
Hier sind nur zwei.
But we know, in Ezekiel 1, for instance, and also in Revelation 4, it's four, right?
Also in Ezekiel 1 zum Beispiel und auch in Offenbarung 4 sehen wir, dass es vier sind.
And we know in the sanctuary, Moses' tabernacle, the only two cherubims. On either side, right?
Und im Heiligtum wissen wir, bei Moses Stiftshütte waren nur zwei Cherubim an der jeweiligen Seite.
But in Solomon's temple you had then also these two big ones in addition to the two little ones on the ark.
Okay. Aber in Salomos Tempel gab es noch zusätzlich zu den zweien auf der Bundeslade diese zwei großen Cherubim.
So, in total four, right?
Insgesamt vier.
So, just go also to Revelation chapter 11.
Geht auch noch zur Offenbarung 11.
Verse 3 and 4.
Vers 3 und 4.
It says, and I will give power unto my two witnesses, and they shall prophesy 1,260 days, clothed in sackcloth. So here they are called two witnesses, right?
Hier werden sie zwei Zeugen genannt.
These are the two olive trees. So the two witnesses are the two olive trees, therefore they are also the...
Die zwei Zeugen sind die zwei Ölbäume, deswegen sind sie auch die zwei.
Yeah, the two anointed ones, right?
Gesalbten.
Yeah, okay. Because it goes on to say, these are the two olive trees and the two candlesticks standing before the God of the earth. Right? That's what it said about the two anointed ones. They stood before the Lord of all the earth.
Da stand auch über die zwei Gesalbten, dass sie vor dem Herrn der Erde standen.
Yes? Okay, good. So, and yes, so in Revelation chapter 4, let's turn there please.
Und in Offenbarung 4 gehen wir da auch noch bitte hin.
Verse 5 to 7.
Verse 5 bis 7.
And out of one of the throne proceeded lightnings and thunderings and voices. And there are seven lamps of fire burning before the throne, which are the seven spirits of God. And before the throne there was a sea of glass like unto crystal. And in the midst of the throne and round about the throne were four beasts, full of eyes before and behind. So here we have these four cherubims, right?
Hier haben wir diese vier Cherubim.
Four beasts, right?
Vier Tiere.
And what's interesting is that the seven lamps are also before the throne.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And they are seven spirits. And
yes.
The four beasts are before the throne and they are also four spirits.
Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly.
Was interessant ist, also diese sieben Lampen, die sind auch vor dem Thron und sie werden auch sieben Geister genannt und diese vier Tiere sind auch vor dem Thron und sind die vier Geister.
It says the angels are ministering spirits, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Und es sagt, die Engel sind dienende Geister.
Because we saw, right, in the camp meeting we looked at this, that this is the candlestick here in verse 5, right?
Yes. Weil beim Camp Meeting haben wir gesehen, dass das in Vers 5 der Leuchter ist.
The anointed ones are the cherubims on the side of it, right?
Exactly.
Die Gesalbten sind die Cherubim, die an der jeweiligen Seite davon stehen.
And the cherubims are on either side of it, but they were also called the two olive trees are two candlesticks, right?
Die Cherubim waren an der jeweiligen Seite, aber sie wurden auch eben diese zwei Ölbäume oder zwei Leuchter genannt.
So, but Revelation chapter 4 tells us there are four.
Aber Offenbarung 4 sagt uns, dass es vier sind.
Yes. So you have now four candlesticks in the sense to the one.
They look like fir trees.
Also in dem Sinne haben wir jetzt vier Leuchter zwischen dem an der jeweiligen Seite von dem einen.
Okay, so yeah, so you have these four cherubims as candlesticks also.
Das sind diese vier Cherubim, die auch Leuchter sind.
And let's go back to chapter 4, verse 7.
Gehen wir zurück zu Kapitel 4, Vers 7.
It says, and the first beast was like a lion, and the second beast like a calf, and the third beast had a face as a man, and the fourth beast was like a flying eagle. So these cherubims are illustrated as four beasts, right?
Diese Cherubim werden wie vier Tiere dargestellt.
What did Daniel see coming out of the sea?
Was hat Daniel aus dem Meer kommen sehen?
Four beasts, right?
Vier Tiere.
But in Daniel, these were obviously Satan's counterfeit of the true four
Aber
beasts, right?
In Daniel,
Revelation 4. Verse 7.
Die gefälschten Tiere. Wir haben Offenbarung 4, Vers 7 gelesen.
Okay, so you have these four beasts. Yeah. And now when you go to chapter 6.
Also hier gibt es diese vier Tiere und gehen wir jetzt zu Kapitel 6.
This is one of the reasons why I say that they're single candlesticks. Because this candlestick in the middle is the seven spirits.
Mm-hmm.
But these four horses are likened unto four spirits.
Mm-hmm.
So they must be single.
Yes, could be. Mm-hmm.
Also es mag sein, dass diese vier Leuchter eigentlich einzelne Kerzen sozusagen sind, nicht so siebenarmige, weil es sagt ja, das sind vier Geister.
Okay, so they would then look more like...
You said they were four spirits?
No, it's just that it says it in Zechariah 6.
Yes.
Right, so if the candlestick seven spirits, it's just a simple thing. Plus, in Revelation 1, it says, I turned and I saw seven candlesticks, but it's one candlestick, right? Mm-hmm. So these are the two candlesticks, and there are four spirits, there's four candlesticks. There's the seven spirits, there's seven candlesticks, but this candlestick in the middle is likened unto one because it represents the church that are all grafted into the true vine, which is Christ. Whereas they are individual candlesticks.
Okay, also das mag wahrscheinlich so aussehen, weil also sagt er, dass Johannes hat diesen siebenarmigen Leuchter gesehen. Und das stellt dar, wie die Gemeinde, sie ist alle in Christus eingepfropft, also sie sind alle eins.
Yeah. Jesus says, I am the vine, you are the branches, right? The seven branches of the candlestick.
Ja, aber Jesus sagt, ich bin der Weinstock, ihr seid die Zweige oder die Reben, dieser siebenarmige Leuchter.
And they are seven spirits.
Und sie sind sieben Geister. Und in Zachariah haben wir gelesen, dass es eben vier Geister sind, diese vier Cherubim, deswegen müssen sie dann so dargestellt werden.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Exactly. So that would be the most logical conclusion at the moment, right?
Also im Moment wäre das die logischste Schlussfolgerung.
Okay, so let's go to Revelation 6.
Gehen wir zu Offenbarung 6.
And let's begin in verse 1.
Und wir fangen in Vers 1 an.
It says, and I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard as it were the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, come and see. And I saw, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow, and a crown was given unto him, and he went forth conquering and to conquer. So here we see this first beast is now linked to this first horse, right?
Hier sehen wir, wie das erste Tier mit dem ersten Pferd verbunden ist.
This the white horse.
Das ist das weiße Pferd.
And we understand this first seal is opened here at the beginning of time of peace. Right?
Wir verstehen, dass das erste Siegel hier am Anfang der Zeit des Friedens geöffnet wird.
Church triumph.
Yes, church triumph.
Führende Gemeinde.
So then in verse 3 and 4.
Und dann Vers 3 und 4.
And when he had opened the second seal, I heard the second beast say, come and see. So it's now the second beast.
Das ist das zweite Tier.
And there went out another horse that was red, and power was given unto him that sat on that sat thereon to take peace from the earth, and that they should kill one another, and there was given unto him a great sword. So therefore we can see when the second seal opens, it's a red horse, and it's the end of the time of peace, right?
Wir können sehen, wenn das zweite Siegel sich öffnet, das ist ein rotes Pferd und das ist das Ende der Zeit des Friedens.
Yeah, and he has a sword now, right?
Und er hat ein Schwert.
So it's the now nation against nation, kingdom against kingdom, right?
Das ist jetzt Nation gegen Nation, Königreich gegen Königreich.
Yeah, it's also the sword that's coming upon the land.
Das ist auch das Schwert, was über das Land kommt.
Yes, but and it says here that they should kill one another, right?
Hier sagt es, dass sie einander töten sollen.
Okay, so and this is what Jesus said on the Mount of Olives, right? He was here at the beginning of the time of peace, but he predicted that there will be wars and rumors of wars, and therefore a time of war again. Okay.
Deswegen, also hier, Jesus war auf dem Ölberg und hat dann vorhergesagt, hat hierauf gewiesen über das Sonntagsgesetz, wenn Kriege und Kriegsgerüchte sein werden, also eine Zeit des Krieges.
Okay, so that would be the second seal.
Das wäre das zweite Siegel.
So, and then you have the third seal, which is this black horse, which is connected to the third beast, and you have the fourth seal, which is this pale horse, okay?
Also dann gibt es das dritte Siegel, oder das dritte Pferd, dieses schwarze Pferd, das ist verbunden mit dem dritten Tier, und dann gibt es noch das vierte Pferd.
And as we understand, so the third seal would also be here when this darkness comes now on this world, okay?
Wie wir verstehen, das dritte Siegel wäre auch hier, wenn diese Finsternis über die Welt kommt.
This black horse, okay?
Dieses schwarze Pferd.
And then the fourth seal is this pale horse, which was the papal rule in history, right?
Und das vierte Siegel wäre dieses fahle Pferd, und das war in der Geschichte die Herrschaft des päpstlichen Roms.
Which would be then here the sixth plague, the great tribulation.
Okay? Das wäre hier in der sechsten Plage die große Trübsal.
Okay, good. But the point is, we can see here that these four beasts, which are these four spirits, they are connected with the four horses of the seals. Right?
Der Punkt ist, diese vier Tiere, was die vier Geister sind, die sind hier verbunden mit diesen vier Pferden der Siege.
Yes. Okay, and this is also what we could see in Zechariah chapter 6, right?
Und das konnten wir auch in Zechariah 6 sehen.
Okay, so just go back to Zechariah 6, please.
Geht bitte zurück zu Zechariah 6.
And because in Zechariah 6 it says here in verse 5.
Weil hier Zechariah 6 Vers 5 sagt es.
About these four chariots with horses.
Über diese vier Streitwagen mit Pferden.
And the angel answered and said unto me, these are the four spirits of the heavens which go forth from standing before the Lord of all the earth. Right? So
they're commanded to hold the four winds there, right?
Ihnen wird ja befohlen, die vier Winde dort zu halten.
Yes. Okay, so here we have these four spirits illustrated as these chariots with the horses, okay?
Also diese vier Geister werden dargestellt durch diese vier Streitwagen mit den vier Pferden.
Who else wrote a chariot in the Bible?
Wer noch hat einen Streitwagen geritten in der Bibel?
Joseph, right?
Joseph.
Just go to Genesis 41.
Geht zu 1. Mose 41.
And then let's read verse 40. We can actually begin in verse 41 to 43.
Wir können Vers 41 anfangen und bis 43 lesen.
And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, see, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt. And Pharaoh took off his ring from his hand and put it upon Joseph's hand, and arrayed him in vesture of fine linen, and put a gold chain about his neck. And he made him to ride in the second chariot which he had. And they cried before him, bow the knee. And he made him ruler over all the land of Egypt. So here he rides in this chariot, right?
Hier reitet in dem Streitwagen.
And where would this be on the line that he does so?
Wo wäre das auf der Linie, dass das macht?
I mean, in this case, it's Mark when he comes out of prison.
Oh, was?
It's at the
here, right?
Yeah.
Es war hier.
Okay, so because
that's a triumphal entry.
Yeah, he stood now here before Pharaoh, right? Explained him here the dream.
Er stand hier vor dem Pharao und hat ihm den Traum erklärt.
And now Pharaoh gives him the rewards at the end, right?
Und dann gibt ihm der Pharao am Ende die.
He's now in the chariot, and what does he do now?
Also er gibt ihm den Lohn, und er ist jetzt im Streitwagen. Was macht er?
Yes, so just read here verse 46.
Geht durch das Land Ägypten. Lesen wir Vers 46.
Of even 45 to 46.
Also 45 bis 46.
And Pharaoh called Joseph's name Zaphnath-Paneah, and he gave him to wife Asenath, the daughter of Potipharah, priest of On. And Joseph went out over all the land of Egypt. And Joseph was 30 years old when he stood before Pharaoh, king of Egypt. And Joseph went out from the presence of Pharaoh and went throughout all the land of Egypt. So he now goes in this chariot throughout Egypt, right?
Also in diesem Streitwagen geht er jetzt durch das Land Ägypten.
Yes, because that would be now the midnight cry he gives, right?
Das wäre nämlich der Mitternachtsruf, den er gibt.
And according to Matthew 22,
gemäß Matthäus 22,
the message goes to whom here?
Wohin geht die Botschaft?
To the highway and the hedges, the Gentiles, right?
Zu den Hecken und Zäunen, das sind die Heiden.
This is illustrated by this wife that he now gets. Who was he marrying here?
Und das wird dargestellt durch diese Frau, die er jetzt bekommt. Wen hat er geheiratet?
Yeah, this Gentile Asenath, the daughter of Potiphar, right?
Diese heidnische Frau Asenath, also die Tochter von Potiphar.
So meaning now the Gentiles will begin to be joined to God's people.
Das bedeutet jetzt, dass die Heiden sich anschließen werden zu Gottes Volk.
Okay, good. Now let's go back to the book of Zechariah.
Gehen wir jetzt zurück zum Buch Zechariah.
Chapter 1.
Kapitel 1.
And let's begin again in verse 8.
Fangen
wir in Vers 8 nochmal an. It says, I saw by night, and behold a man riding upon a red horse, and he stood upon among the myrtle trees that were in the bottom, and behind him were their red horses speckled in white. So there's this man, and he stands now among the myrtle trees, right?
Das ist dieser Mann, und er steht unter den Myrtenbäumen.
And then said I, O my Lord, what are these? And the angel that talked with me said unto me, I will show thee what these be. And the man that stood among the myrtle trees answered and said, These are they whom the Lord hath sent to walk to and fro through the earth. So, that's exactly what we read in chapter 6, verse 7, right?
Das ist genau, was wir in Kapitel 6, Vers 7 gelesen haben.
Let's just go to... actually we didn't read verse 7, but let's go back to chapter 6 and read verse 5 to 7.
Also wir haben das noch nicht gelesen, aber gehen wir zurück zu Zechariah 6 und lesen noch Verse 5 bis 7.
It says, And the angel answered and said unto me, These are the four spirits of the heavens which go forth from standing before the Lord of all the earth. The black horses which are therein go forth into the north country, and the white go forth after them, and the grizzled go forth toward the south country. And the bay went forth and sought to go, that they might walk to and fro through the earth. And he said, Get ye hence, walk to and fro through the earth. So they walk to and fro through the earth. So what do they do?
Was machen sie?
Walk to and fro.
Walk to and fro through the earth. Right?
Wandeln auf und ab auf der Erde.
That's what we read in Chapter 1, verse 10, right?
Das haben wir in Kapitel 1, Vers 10 gelesen.
Okay. So, and it says here, the Lord sent them to walk to and fro through the earth.
Und es sagt, der Herr hat sie gesandt, um hin und her auf der Erde zu wandeln.
Now verse 11.
Jetzt Vers 11.
And they, that's these horses, okay.
Diese Pferde hier.
And they answered the angel of the Lord that stood among the myrtle trees. So who's there for the man that stands on the among the myrtle trees?
Deswegen, wer ist der Mann, der unter den Myrtenbäumen steht?
The angel of the Lord, right?
Der Engel des Herrn.
So it's Christ.
Das ist also Christus.
So Christ is therefore this rider on this red horse who stood among the myrtle trees.
Deswegen,
right?
Christus ist also dieser Reiter auf dem roten Pferd, der unter den Myrtenbäumen stand.
So and they answered the angel of the Lord that stood among the myrtle trees and said, We have walked to and fro through the earth. And behold, all the earth sitteth still and is at rest. Okay, so therefore, they done their work, and now they came to what time?
Deswegen, sie haben jetzt ihr Werk getan, und zu welcher Zeit sind sie gekommen?
Time of peace, right?
Zeit des Friedens.
Because it says the earth is now still and at rest.
Es sagt, okay. Die Erde ist jetzt still und ist ruhig.
So let's see why this is a time of peace.
Schauen wir an, warum es eine Zeit des Friedens ist.
It's obvious, but...
I mean, these must be the ones in... Not all of them, but the horses in Revelation 6, for instance, the rider
changes, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what I'm saying, the rider on the horse that's red is Satan.
Yes.
The rider on the horse that's red is Christ. So there must be a.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Also in Offenbarung 6, der Reiter auf dem roten Pferd ist eigentlich Satan, aber hier in Zechariah ist der Reiter auf dem roten Pferd Christus.
Yes, in Revelation 6, yeah, you have. Only Christ was sitting there on the white horse, right?
Also in Offenbarung 6 ist es also nur Christus, der auf dem weißen Pferd sitzt.
And on all the other horses, Satan sits on them.
Und auf den anderen Pferden sitzt Satan.
But here you see Christ sitting also on the red horse.
Aber hier sehen wir, dass Christus auch auf dem roten Pferd sitzt.
Okay. But now let's go to Isaiah chapter 14.
Jetzt gehen wir zu Jesaja 14.
Just to see that when the earth is at, still and sitteth at rest, or sitteth still and is at rest.
Zu sehen, dass wenn
this is the time of peace.
Wenn die Erde still und ruhig ist, dass das eine Zeit des Friedens ist.
So Isaiah 14.
Jesaja 14.
And this speaks about the punishment on Babylon.
Das spricht über die Bestrafung über Babylon.
Verse 4 to 7.
Verse 4 bis 7.
And thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon and say, how hath the oppressor ceased, the golden city ceased. So what about the oppressor now?
Was ist mit dem Unterdrücker?
Ceased.
Er hat aufgehört.
And who is the oppressor here in verse 4?
Wer ist der Unterdrücker in Vers 4?
King of Babylon.
Der König von Babylon.
So Babylon is ceased now.
Babylon hat jetzt aufgehört.
Verse 5.
Vers 5.
The Lord hath broken the staff of the wicked and the scepter of the rulers. He who smote the people in wrath with a continual stroke, he that ruled the nations in anger is persecuted and none hindereth. The whole earth is at rest and is quiet. They break forth into singing. So here we see when he's punished, the earth is at rest and is quiet.
Hier sehen wir, wenn er bestraft wird, dann ist die ganze Erde ruhig und still.
Okay, so it's therefore a time of peace.
Right? Deswegen ist es eine Zeit des Friedens.
Good. So let's go back to Zechariah 1.
Gehen wir zurück zu Zechariah 1.
And let's go to verse 12.
Gehen wir zu Vers 12.
But I want to lay out basically that because Zechariah, who would be Zechariah of these prophets?
Also wer von den Propheten wäre Zechariah?
Would he be...
So
he would be among those first prophets, right?
Er wäre unter diesen ersten Propheten, so wie Joel.
So therefore he gives now the message to this next group here, right?
Er gibt also die Botschaft zur nächsten Gruppe.
He speaks to Jeff and Paminda and says, don't be like your fathers, okay?
Er spricht zu Jeff und Paminda und sagt, seid nicht wie eure Väter.
And so therefore he sees now those things that pertain to this group, and this group finishes with the destruction of Jerusalem, right?
Sieht also die Dinge, die jetzt zu dieser Gruppe mit ihr passieren, und das hört ja auch bei der Zerstörung von Jerusalem.
Okay, and when Jerusalem gets destroyed, is there also a time of peace?
Und wenn Jerusalem zerstört wird, gibt es da auch eine Zeit des Friedens?
Yes, right?
Yeah.
So this short time of peace here after the punishment,
die
right?
Kurze Zeit des Friedens nach der Bestrafung.
Okay, so this is where I would place it, because when we continue.
Da würde ich das platzieren, weil wenn wir jetzt weiterlesen.
Verse 12.
Vers 12.
Then the angel of the Lord answered and said, O Lord of hosts, how long wilt thou not have mercy on Jerusalem and on the cities of Judah against which thou hast had indignation these 70 years? So what did the Lord have against his people?
Was hatte der Herr gegen sein Volk?
Indignation, right?
So.
And we looked at this also in a past study.
In einem vergangenen Studium haben wir uns das schon angeschaut.
Let's go to Daniel 11.
Gehen wir zu Daniel 11.
So keep your finger always in Zechariah.
Haltet euren Finger immer in Zechariah.
Daniel 11.
Daniel 11.
Verse 36.
Vers 36.
Because we must always discern which indignation is meant, right?
Weil wir müssen immer unterscheiden, welcher Zorn gemeint ist.
How many indignations are there?
Wie viele Zorne gibt es?
The point is, there's one indignation against God's people and there's one indignation against the Gentiles. Okay.
Es gibt einen Zorn gegen sein Volk und einen Zorn gegen die Heiden.
Okay, so when God is indignant with his own people, what does he then allow?
Wenn Gott zornig ist mit seinem eigenen Volk, was erlaubt er?
That the heathen might rule over them.
Dass die Heiden über sie herrschen.
So when God is now indignant with the heathen, this when he punishes them.
Okay. Wenn Gott mit den Heiden zornig ist, dann bestraft er sie.
So let's go to Daniel 11:36.
Gehen wir zu Daniel 11, Vers 36.
It says, and the king shall do according to his will, and he shall exalt himself and magnify himself above every god, and shall speak marvelous things against the God of gods, and shall prosper till the indignation be accomplished. For that that is determined shall be done. So who is this king in verse 36?
Wer ist dieser König in Vers 36?
This is the Pope, right? But it's Satan. Okay, and Satan is this one that exalts himself above every god, right? So when he's ruling over you, this is typifying when Isaiah 19, which is also the punishment of the Gentiles. And what I'm saying is there's only one indignation, but one typifies the other. That's why she says the destruction of Jerusalem illustrates the destruction of the world, because it's when you're going to be given into the hands of Satan, and he's going to exercise his wickedness over you. And the only difference is that there's times where it's done in mercy, that's the type, and then there's times where it's done without mercy. But even when it's done without mercy, he's still typifying, you know, this point in the future where probation is closed and you're given.
I don't think so, because this indignation that will come against the wicked is always the punishment that then. We will just look at this, okay? Let's just go to Daniel 11, verse 36 now, and let's first.
So the seven last plagues are not illustrated in the 1260?
They are.
Okay, so is that not God's indignation? Okay, so
it's God's wrath, yeah.
It's the same thing.
But it's not the same illustration as this.
You're reading about the Pope ruling over them, yes. Right? For 1260.
Yes.
Okay.
And he will prosper during this time, right?
Okay, so that's what I'm saying. That's the seven last plagues.
In one illustration, yes. Okay, but. Okay, let's just look at this. Okay, let's go to Daniel 11, verse 36.
Also gehen wir zu Daniel 11, Vers 36.
Because I think there's one thing not considered here. Okay. So, it says here, so this king is the king of the north, right?
Der König ist der König des Nordens.
So, and he prospers now, why and until when?
Er gedeiht jetzt, weshalb und bis wann?
What does it say?
Was sagt es?
Yeah, until the indignation be accomplished.
Bis
okay.
Der Zorn vollendet ist.
So, and let's go also to Isaiah chapter 10.
Gehen wir auch zu Jesaja 10.
And this indignation that God has against his people.
Das ist der Zorn, den Gott gegen sein Volk hat.
Because in Isaiah 10, verse 5 to 6.
Jesaja 10, Vers 5 bis 6.
It says, O Assyrian, the rod of mine anger and the staff in their hand is mine indignation. So what is the staff in the Assyrian's hand?
Was ist der Stab in der Hand des Assyrers?
Indignation.
God's indignation. Right?
Gottes Zorn.
But it's God's indignation against his own people.
Aber es ist Gottes Zorn gegen sein eigenes Volk.
Because it says, I will send him against an hypocritical nation, against the people of my wrath, will I give him a charge to take the spoil and take the prey, to tread them down like the mire of the streets. And then in verse 24,
Vers 24
to 25, it says,
bis Vers 25.
Therefore, thus saith the Lord God of hosts, all my people that dwellest in Zion, be not afraid of the Assyrian. He shall smite thee with a rod, and shall lift up his staff against thee after the manner of Egypt. For yet a very little while, and the indignation shall cease, and mine anger in their destruction. Right, so when God's indignation ceases against his people, what will happen?
Also wenn Gottes Zorn gegen sein Volk aufhört, was wird passieren?
Punish the man of sin.
Yeah, you will punish the king of the north, right?
Er wird den König des Nordens bestrafen.
So he punishes the oppressor. Okay?
Also bestraft den Unterdrücker.
So the indignation is only upon you because of your sins, right?
Und dieser Zorn ist ja nur über dich wegen deinen Sünden.
And when we go to Micah 7,
gehen wir zu Micha 7.
Micah verse 8.
Vers 8.
Actually, we can even begin in verse 7.
Okay. Wir können doch in Vers 7 anfangen.
Speaks about this time of trouble here.
Da spricht über diese Zeit der Trübsal.
Says, therefore I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Rejoice not against me, O mine enemy. When I fall, I shall arise, and when I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be a light unto me. I will bear the indignation of the Lord, because I have sinned against him, until he plead my cause and execute judgment for me. He will bring me forth to light, and I shall behold his righteousness. Then she that is mine enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her, which said unto me, Where is the Lord thy God? And mine eyes shall behold her, now shall she be trodden down as the mire of the streets. Okay, so she is permitted to rule over you because of what?
Ihr wird erlaubt, über dir zu herrschen, wegen was?
Because of your sin.
Yeah, because of your sin.
Wegen deiner Sünde.
Therefore, the indignation of God is against you. You must bear it, right?
Deswegen der Zorn Gottes ist über dir oder gegen dich und du musst es ertragen.
Until he does what for you?
Bis er was für dich macht?
Execute. Until he executes judgment.
Right? Bis er Gericht ausführt.
Then all turned around, now she is trodden down like the mire of the streets, right?
Dann wird es alles umgedreht, dann wird sie wie der Kot auf der Gasse zertreten.
Because it said the Assyrian would come against God's people and would tread them down like the mire of the streets. That's what we read in Isaiah 10 verse 6, right?
Wir haben in Jesaja 10 Vers 6 gelesen, dass der Assyrer gegen Gottes Volk kommen wird und sie zertreten wird wie den Kot auf der Gasse.
Okay, because it says here in verse in Isaiah 51.
Und in Jesaja 51 sagt es.
Verse 22 to 23.
Vers 22 bis 23.
Thus saith the Lord, thus saith thy Lord, the Lord, and thy God that pleadeth the cause of his people. Behold, I have taken out of thine hand the cup of trembling, even the dregs of the cup of my fury. Thou shalt no more drink it again. But I will put it into the hand of them that afflict thee, which have said to thy soul, Bow down, that we may go over, and thou hast laid thy body as the ground, as the street to them that went over. Okay, so now he takes the cup out of your hand and gives it to the enemies, right?
Jetzt nimmt er den Kelch aus deiner Hand und gibt es deinen Feinden.
So now the indignation turns away from his people to God's enemies.
Okay? Jetzt wendet sich der Zorn weg von Gottes Volk hin zu seinen Feinden.
Okay, so if we go now back to Zechariah chapter 1.
Gehen wir zurück zu Zechariah 1.
In verse 12 it said that the Lord had 70 years indignation with his people, right?
Vers 12 hat es gesagt, dass der Herr 70 Jahre Zorn hatte gegen sein Volk.
But then obviously the indignation now ceased because he says now I return with mercies. Okay?
Aber jetzt hat der Zorn aufgehört, weil er sagt, ich werde jetzt zurückkehren mit Gnaden.
And therefore the earth is at rest.
Okay? Deswegen ist die Erde jetzt ruhig.
So let's read verse 13.
Lesen wir Vers 13.
And the Lord answered the angel that talked with me with good words and with comfortable words. So the angel that communed with me said unto me, Cry thou, saying, Thus saith the Lord of hosts, I am jealous for Jerusalem and for Zion with a great jealousy. So what is he to do now, according to verse 14?
Was soll er gemäß Vers 14 tun?
Give the midnight cry.
Den Mitternachtsruf geben.
And I am very sore displeased with the heathen that are at ease. For I was but a little displeased, and they helped forward the affliction. So now he is displeased. He's, now the indignation turns against the heathen and not against his people anymore.
Also jetzt ist er unzufrieden. Jetzt ist der Zorn nicht mehr gegen Gottes Volk, sondern gegen die Heiden.
Verse 16.
Vers 16.
Therefore, thus saith the Lord, I am returned to Jerusalem with mercies. My house shall be built in it, saith the Lord of hosts, and a line shall be stretched forth upon Jerusalem. So, what does he say now?
Was sagt jetzt?
Give the cry, and what shall be built?
Gib den Ruf, und was wird gebaut werden?
Temple, right?
Der Tempel.
So it says here, Christ says, tear down this temple, and in 3 days I will rebuild it, right?
Also Christus sagt ja hier, reißt diesen Tempel nieder, und in 3 Tagen werde ich ihn wieder aufbauen.
Okay. During the midnight cry, right? The midnight cry is what builds the temple. Okay?
Während des Mitternachtsrufs, weil es ist der Mitternachtsruf, der den Tempel wieder aufbaut.
And therefore it says in verse 17.
In Vers 17 sagt es,
cry yet, saying, thus saith the Lord of hosts, my cities through prosperity shall yet be spread abroad, and the Lord shall yet comfort Zion, and shall yet choose Jerusalem. Right? Pointing to future, when the temple is built. Right?
Und er weist jetzt auf die Zukunft hin, wenn der Tempel gebaut wird.
Okay, so here Zechariah stands and he gets this promise of what will be accomplished here. Okay.
Also Zechariah steht hier und er erhält jetzt die Verheißung, die dann da am Ende kommen wird.
So the promise is that he will comfort Zion and shall choose Jerusalem, right?
Also die Verheißung ist, dass er Zion trösten wird und Jerusalem erwählen wird.
Okay, but when you go now to Zechariah chapter 3,
wenn ihr jetzt aber zu Zechariah 3 geht,
then you can see when the Lord always chooses Jerusalem.
Da kann man sehen, wenn der Herr, wann der Herr Jerusalem immer wählt.
So let's read verse 1 and 2.
Lesen wir Vers 1 und 2.
And he showed me Joshua the high priest standing before the angel of the Lord, and Satan standing at his right hand to resist him. And the Lord said unto Satan, the Lord rebuke thee, O Satan, even the Lord that hath chosen Jerusalem rebuke thee. Is not this a brand plucked out of the fire? So when did he choose Jerusalem?
Wann hat er Jerusalem gewählt?
When he plucked him out of the fire.
Yeah, when he plucks him out of the fire and blots out the sin, right?
Wenn er sie aus dem Feuer reißt und ihre Sünden austilgt.
Okay. So therefore it points forward to this. When he says here, I shall yet choose Jerusalem again, he points here forward when the sins will be blotted out, when the temple is finished building, also, or when it's built, okay?
Wenn er sagt, ich werde Jerusalem
wieder wählen,
dann weist es eben vorwärts, wenn eben der Tempel wieder aufgebaut ist, vollendet ist.
Yes. Okay, when the sins are blotted out.
Wenn
okay.
ihre Sünden ausgetickt.
Good. So, but when you go back to Zechariah 1,
es geht aber nochmal zurück zu Zechariah 1,
in verse 16.
In Vers 16.
It says, therefore thus saith the Lord, I am returned to Jerusalem with mercies. My house shall be built in it, saith the Lord of hosts, and a line shall be stretched forth upon Jerusalem. Okay, so what will he do?
Was wird er tun?
Stretch
a
line.
Yeah, he will stretch forth a line, right?
Wird eine Linie ausziehen.
So there's a measuring going forth here, right?
Also hier findet ein Messen statt.
And this you can also see then in chapter 2, verse 1.
Das kann man dann auch in Kapitel 2, Vers 1 lesen.
But it's also in Revelation 11, in the sixth plague, they were measuring. So this is just the next group.
Und in Offenbarung 11, da kann man das Messen in der sechsten Plage sehen. Und das hier in Zechariah wäre jetzt für die nächste Gruppe.
Yes, so let's go to chapter 2, verse 1.
Gehen wir jetzt zu Kapitel 2, Vers 1. Und im Deutschen ist es 2, Vers 5.
It says, I lifted up mine eyes again and looked, and behold a man with a measuring line in his hand. Then said I, whither goest thou? And he said unto me, to measure Jerusalem, to see what is the breadth thereof and what is the length thereof. So he now measures here Jerusalem, right?
Er misst jetzt Jerusalem.
Okay. So the point I want to make is that you can see there's a measuring going forth here, okay?
Den Punkt, den ich mache, man kann sehen, hier findet ein Messen statt.
And he also then says in verse 6 and 7.
Und in Vers 6 und 7 sagt dann auch.
He says, ho, ho, come forth and flee from the land of the north, saith the Lord. For I have spread you abroad as the four winds of heaven, saith the Lord. Deliver thyself, O Zion, that dwellest with the daughter of Babylon. So that's the midnight cry message, right?
Also das ist die Mitternachtsrufbotschaft, kommt aus Babylon heraus.
Good. Now let's go to Ezekiel, chapter 40.
Geht jetzt zu Ezekiel 40.
Ezekiel 40.
Ezekiel 40.
Verse 2.
Vers 2.
It says, in the visions of God brought he me into the land of Israel and set me upon a very high mountain, by which was as the frame of a city on the south. And he brought me thither, and behold, there was a man whose appearance was like the appearance of brass, with a line of flax in his hand and a measuring reed, and he stood in the gate. And the man said unto me, Son of man, behold with thine eyes, and hear with thine ears, and set thine heart upon all that I shall show thee. For to the intent that I might show them unto thee art thou brought hither. Declare all that thou seest to the house of Israel. So it's the same command given to John, right, in Revelation 1.
Das ist dasselbe Gebot, was auch Johannes in Kapitel 1 gegeben wird.
Where it says, what thou seest, write unto the seven churches.
Er sagt, das, was du siehst, schreibe den sieben Gemeinden.
So this would be down.
Yeah.
In the investigation.
Yes, exactly. Das wäre beim Untersuchungsgericht.
I mean, obviously for Ezekiel would be earlier, his earlier group, but in principle, let's just stick now with this illustration, would be here, right?
Also Ezekiel ist früher, er ist ja eine Gruppe davor, aber vom Prinzip ist es dasselbe. Wir bleiben jetzt bei der Darstellung, also das wäre hier.
Okay, and what does he now do? The man with a measuring reed, he now measures the temple, right?
Der Mann mit der Messrute, er misst jetzt den Tempel.
So, in the next two chapters, in three chapters, it's all about measuring the temple.
Okay? In den nächsten drei Kapiteln geht es um das Messen des Tempels.
In one day, when we're filled with the Holy Ghost, we'll understand these chapters, okay?
Eines Tages, wenn wir mit dem Heiligen Geist gefüllt sind, werden wir diese Kapitel verstehen.
Okay. Maybe in eternity we'll understand it.
Vielleicht in der Ewigkeit können wir es mal verstehen.
Yes. No, but that's true. Yeah.
Also wir müssen es eigentlich hier verstehen, weil wir müssen ja das Muster dann den anderen zeigen.
Because everything that is written in the Bible is for us, right? We need to understand everything. Okay.
Also es sagt, alles, was in der Bibel geschrieben ist, ist für uns geschrieben. Also wir müssen alles verstehen.
Yes. Everything pertains to the plan of salvation.
Alles gehört zum Erlösungsplan.
Okay, but the point I want to make is that this measuring in Ezekiel now takes place in the investigative judgment, right?
Aber den Punkt, den ich zeigen möchte, also dieses Messen hier in Ezekiel findet im Untersuchungsgericht statt.
Okay, and what does he see? He sees the temple, right, being measured. Who is the temple?
Und er sieht, wie der Tempel gemessen wird. Und wer ist der Tempel?
I mean, it's just like John saw the candlestick.
Yes.
And he saw the and poured an oil into it. So it's the same illustration, what you see it, because it leads down to the point where the glory fills it. So it's the same illustration.
Yes, so they all saw always Christ in the midst of the two anointed ones, right?
Sie haben immer Christus inmitten der zwei Gesalbten gesehen.
So they always saw the candlestick in order that they can then become the candlestick themselves, right?
Sie haben immer den Leuchter gesehen, damit sie dann selber der Leuchter werden können.
Or they saw the temple in order that they could become the temple themselves.
Oder sie haben den Tempel gesehen, damit sie selbst zum Tempel werden konnten.
So Ezekiel sees now Christ as the temple being measured, and he sees how perfect his character is, and he now gets humbled in the dust because of this. Okay.
Ezekiel sieht jetzt Christus als der Tempel, wie er jetzt vermessen wird, und
and then he gets humbled in the dust because of that. Okay.
Und er wird in den Staub gedemütigt, weil er sieht, dass er nicht so ist.
Because we saw, let's just keep your finger here. Let's go quickly back to 2 Corinthians chapter 3.
Ja, wir haben das schon gesehen. Halte deinen Finger hier und geht zu 2. Korinther 3.
Yeah, we covered this also in the last presentations at the camp meeting.
In den letzten Vorträgen beim Camp Meeting haben wir das auch behandelt.
So 2 Corinthians chapter 3, last verse of the chapter.
2. Korinther 3 und der letzte Vers des Kapitels.
But we all with open face beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even as by the Spirit of the Lord. Right? So, where do you see the glory of the Lord?
Wo siehst du die Herrlichkeit des Herrn?
Yeah, when he passes by before you, right?
Untersuchungsgericht, wenn er an dir vorüberzieht.
So, and now you look on this glory and what happens to you?
Jetzt schaust du auf diese Herrlichkeit und was passiert mit dir gemäß diesem Vers?
Change into the same image, right?
Du wirst in dasselbe Ebenbild verändert.
So you behold the candlestick, now at the end you become a candlestick yourself. Isaiah, right?
Du siehst den Leuchter und dann wirst du selber zum Leuchter. Erinnert euch an Jesaja.
You behold the temple, yourself become the temple, that's Ezekiel now, okay?
Du siehst den Tempel und dann wirst du selbst zum Tempel, das ist eben Ezekiel.
So Ezekiel sees the temple, he sees Christ, and at the end of it, he becomes the temple himself, right?
Ezekiel, er sieht den Tempel, der Christus ist, und dann wird er am Ende selber der Tempel.
Okay, good, so, and, so therefore we have a measuring in here, okay?
Deswegen hier drin haben wir ein Messen.
And obviously, while Christ is shown to you and the measurements of Christ, what happens at the same time with you?
Während dir Christus gezeigt wird, also die Maße von Christus, was passiert mit dir?
Yeah, you compare yourself with those measurements, right? And you say, woe is me, okay?
Vergleich dich mit diesen Vermessungen und sagst, wehe mir.
So just go back to Ezekiel 43, verse 10, right?
Zurück zu Ezekiel 43, Vers 10.
Because now here Ezekiel is now the house, the temple, right?
Weil jetzt ist Ezekiel das Haus, dieser Tempel.
And it says here, thou son of man, show the house to the house of Israel, that they may be ashamed of their iniquities, and let them measure the pattern, right? So they now must compare themselves with you, okay?
Sie müssen sich jetzt mit dir vergleichen.
And they will be ashamed of their iniquities, it says. Okay.
Sie werden ihre Ungerechtigkeiten beschämt werden.
Okay, so therefore, yeah, this measuring that goes forth here is then also going forth there. Okay.
Das Messen, was hier vorwärts geht, geht auch hier vorwärts.
And the trumpet.
Yes. And then there's a measuring also going in here. Okay.
Das findet auch ein Messen hier drin
statt. Let's quickly look at this also.
Schauen wir uns das noch schnell an.
Revelation chapter 21.
Offenbarung 21.
And verse 9 to 10.
Vers 9 bis 10.
It says, and there came unto me one of the seven angels which had the seven vials full of the seven last plagues, and talked with me, saying, come hither, I will show thee the bride, the Lamb's wife. So that's the same as, come hither, I will show you the judgment on the great whore, right?
Das ist dasselbe wie, komm hierher und ich werde dir das Gericht über die große Hure zeigen.
Okay. And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain and showed me that great city, the Holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God. So that would be this angel of Revelation 10 coming down, right?
Das wäre dieser Engel von Offenbarung 10, der runterkommt.
Having the glory of God, right?
Und hat die Herrlichkeit Gottes.
And her light was like unto a stone, most precious, even like a jasper stone, clear as crystal. And so on and so forth. And then in verse 15 to 16.
In Vers 15 und 16.
And he that talked with me had a golden reed to measure the city, and the gates thereof, and the wall thereof. And the city lies four square, and the length is as large as the breadth. And he measured the city with a reed 12,000 furlongs. The length and the breadth and the height thereof are equal. And he measured the wall thereof, and so on and so forth. Okay? So here he measures now the holy city. Right?
Hier vermisst er die heilige Stadt.
Okay. So, I mean, I'm open that this can be just the same measuring as in Ezekiel, but I'm more inclined to mark it in here.
No, okay. It can't be, because when you go to Luke 19, tells you there.
Gehen wir zu Lukas 19.
Okay, Luke 19.
Yeah, because in verse 12 it says.
Vers 12.
Says, he said, therefore, a certain nobleman went into a far country to receive for himself a kingdom. Mm-hmm. And it's the golden city, right?
Das ist die goldene Stadt.
And to return. And he called his 10 servants, said, delivered them 10 pounds, and said, then occupy till I come. In verse 15.
Vers 15.
And it came to pass, when he was returned, having received the kingdom. So he returns. When he comes and sits on that throne, so he already has the kingdom, right?
Er kommt zurück und sitzt auf dem Thron und da hat er schon das Königreich.
It says, then he commanded the servants to be called unto him to whom he had given the money, and now he measures them.
Jetzt misst er sie.
The questions.
Yes, it's measuring. Yes.
Diese Frage, diese Fragen, sie messen sie.
Okay, good. So then, this measuring is then Also here, so we're definitely measuring here anyways, okay?
Also hier ist ein Messen, auf jeden Fall gibt es hier ein Messen.
Because what measures you?
Weil was misst dich?
God's word, right?
Gottes Wort. It
says, I will not judge you, but
yes.
The word.
Exactly.
Yeah. Sagt nicht, ich werde euch richten, sondern das Wort.
Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God.
Okay? Der Mensch lebt nicht vom Brot allein, sondern aus jedem Wort Gottes.
So this is what constantly measures you. So the Lord, from the very first moment, puts on the measurement on you, tries you, shows you that how you need to be in order to become this temple. Okay?
Das Wort misst dich und der Herr macht beständig sein Maß an dich und prüft dich und zeigt dir, wie du sein Tempel werden sollst.
So right now at the moment we are measured. Okay?
Also gerade im Moment werden wir gemessen.
And whenever the Lord opens his word to us, he says, this is how you should become. Okay?
Immer wenn der Herr sein Wort uns eröffnet, dann zeigt er uns, so sollst du werden.
Every time he convicts us of our sins, he shows us, you're not as you should be. Okay?
Immer wenn er uns von unseren Sünden überführt, dann zeigt er uns, du bist nicht so, wie du sein solltest.
Sister Way says, everything we do, words, without interacting, the angels are measuring us.
Yes.
Und dann bald sagt, also jedes Mal, alles, was wir tun, all unsere Taten, da wenn wir irgendwo unterwegs sind, dann messen uns die Engel.
Yes. Whenever we sit down here, we are measured. Whenever we speak vanity on Sabbath, we are measured. Okay.
Also wenn wir hier sitzen, dann werden wir vermessen. Wenn wir Torheit am Sabbat sprechen, werden wir gemessen.
Yeah. And always when we realize, wow, I failed, then I know only that I failed because I have a comparison with the true pattern, okay?
Und jedes Mal, wenn wir realisieren, oh, ich habe versagt, dann wissen wir, dass wir versagt haben, weil wir einen Vergleich haben zum wahren Muster.
And the more the Lord builds this pattern in our minds, the clearer we have a perception of how we should actually be, right?
Je mehr der Herr dieses Muster in unserem Verstand aufbaut, desto eine klarere Vorstellung können wir haben, wie wir sein sollen.
And eventually he can reveal himself to us.
Letztendlich kann er sich uns offenbaren.
Then we see clearly, this is how the pattern is, this is how the temple must be. Okay.
Dann sehen wir ganz klar, wie das Muster ist, wie der Tempel sein muss.
And then we will all say, woe's me. Okay.
Dann werden wir alle sagen, wehe mir.
Because we realize it's impossible in our own strength to ever become like this temple. Okay.
Weil wir werden erkennen, es ist unmöglich in unserer eigenen Kraft jemals wie dieser Tempel zu werden.
But if we humble then ourselves, wrestle like Jacob, the Lord will enable us to become like this temple. Okay.
Wenn wir uns demütigen und wie Jakob ringen, dann wird der Herr uns befähigen, diesen Tempel zu werden.
Okay, so therefore that's this final measuring with grace here. Okay.
Deswegen hier ist dieses letzte Messen mit Gnade.
And then we know the final review will sit.
Wir wissen, dann wird sich die finale Überprüfung setzen.
And we saw the books are open again and the same process goes over, but now it's without grace. Okay.
Wir haben gesehen, die Bücher werden sich öffnen und derselbe Prozess wird stattfinden, aber jetzt ohne Gnade.
And we saw for the righteous ones, it's no judgment at all. Okay.
Für die Gerechten haben wir gesehen, es ist gar kein Gericht.
Because the word will fit perfectly fit with your character. Okay.
Weil das Wort wird perfekt mit deinem Charakter passen.
But if you're among the wicked, you will then realize, wow, I'm self-condemned. Okay.
Aber wenn du unter den Bösen bist, wirst du erkennen, ich bin selbstverdammt.
Okay, so therefore we can see same illustration also as or similar illustration as also the sickles, right?
Wir können also sehen, das ist eine ähnliche Darstellung wie mit den Sicheln.
Yeah, because we saw a sickle is thrown in here.
Wir haben gesehen, hier wird eine Sichel reingeworfen.
And then another sickle in here,
eine
right?
Eine weitere Sichel hier drin.
Okay, we don't have an illustration yet where we can see a sickle there, but must be also the same pattern, right?
The Samaritan woman, he was put in the sickle. He explained that when he revealed himself to her, he put in the sickle.
Okay.
And investigative judgment.
Yeah, the Samaritan woman, yes. He saved her, right?
Okay, also im Untersuchungsgericht, da ist auch eine Sichel, weil das haben wir bei der samaritischen Frau, wo er dann, also sie hat ihn angenommen, als er sich offenbart hat.
Yes. So this sickle here is the sickle with mercy, right?
Diese
the gospel message.
Diese Sichel ist diese Botschaft der Gnade.
The sickle with mercy.
Ah, die Sichel mit Gnade.
And this will just be repeated here.
Yeah,
und das wird hier wiederholt werden.
And then which is like this final call, this final measuring, okay?
Das wie dieser letzte Ruf ist, dieses letzte Vermessen.
And then this sickle that goes in here in the final review is just to separate now the two classes.
Okay. Die Sichel, die in der finalen Überprüfung reingeht, ist dann, um die zwei Klassen zu trennen.
Okay, good. So let's take these thoughts. Let us remind ourselves that we are always measured. Okay.
Lass uns diese Gedanken nehmen und uns daran erinnern, dass wir immer gemessen werden.
And that this should be a positive thing, because then we can constantly strive to become like the pattern.
Das okay. sollte was Positives sein, weil dann können wir beständig danach streben, wie das wahre Muster zu werden.
And eventually the Lord can change our character from glory to glory.
Okay. Und letztendlich kann der Herr dann unseren Charakter von Herrlichkeit zu Herrlichkeit verändern.
Into the same image.
In dasselbe Ebenbild.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, good. Then let us close with our prayer round.
Dann lasst uns mit unserer Gebetsrunde abschließen.